Hello, Ilian here, and in this video, we're going to take a look at an overview of all the features that MeshCentral has in terms of security. So let's take a look at that right now. So security is super important, especially when you're dealing with remote management solution where your server is managing, you know, tens, hundreds, thousands of different computers all over the internet. You don't want that server to be a weak point because obviously it's protecting a lot of assets. So let's take a look at some of the features we have for protecting MeshCentral. And what we're gonna do is I'm gonna open a browser here and I am going to go to meshcentral.com. And so this is the main page that you see when you go to that website. And of course, this is the entryway to our public server. So if you go on the upper right here, you can try meshcentral.com for free. Obviously that's a public server. The best is to have your own server. But if you just want to try out MeshCentral, you can just use the public server anytime. So on the main page, there's a link here to security features. It's a PDF. We're going to click on that and we're going to take a quick look at the different features here. The first one on the upper left is two-factor authentication. So basically, passwords are not good enough on the internet these days. You really want to have password plus something else. And usually what you want to do is proof of knowledge, like a password, and proof of possession, for example, a key token or something like that. So in the case of MeshCentral, if I go back to my test server here, you'll notice that when you go into an account, you can set up your two-factor authentication in the account security section right here. So you have managed the authenticator app. This is for Google Authenticator or other OTP. And then you have security keys where you can set, you can add your different security keys for FIDO and so on and so forth. If you set up a SMS on your server, you will have this SMS options and so on and so forth. Super important you guys use that. In addition, there's a configuration that you can add to MeshCentral to require that user use two-factor authentication. Essentially, you'll be able to log in, but you won't be able to do anything important until you set up two-factor authentication. And so if you're a serious administrator, you should really do that. Now, the other one, let's encrypt support. And so if you take a look at, for example, meshcentral.com, that we were just here a minute ago, that meshcentral.com, it says secure connection here with a padlock. But if you go in and look at the certificate, you'll see that it's a list encrypt certificate. So these certificates are valid for usually 90 days, and they're renewed around 45 days. So MeshCentral has built-in support for Let's Encrypt. This allows you to just not have to worry about getting a certificate. MeshCentral will do it for you once it's set up correctly. Now, obviously, you will need to have a domain name assigned and pointing to your MeshCentral server. So the third one I'm going to cover here, strong cryptography. MeshCentral has obviously makes use of cryptography quite a lot. And so the idea is that we use one level above the industry standard. So generally the industry standard would be SHA-256. MeshCentral uses SHA-384. Instead of AES-128, we use AES-256. And instead of RSA-2048, we use RSA-3072. So everything is one step up than the industry standard, which is great. And also there's a fear in the future that it could be some quantum computers and so on. By using a higher level of security like that, you would delay the possibility that those computers, those special quantum computers would be able to crack your crypto. Use of TLS 1.3, as of recording of this video, TLS 1.0 and 1.1 are completely deprecated. They should not be used anymore. And TLS 1.2 and 1.3 are the acceptable ones, MeshCentral fully supports TLS 1.3, including the Mesh agent that connects to MeshCentral by default with TLS 1.3. So that's kind of an additional layer of security right there. Strong password enforcement. This is optional, but you can set up MeshCentral to make sure that your users use strong passwords with different policies. There's also known password libraries that you can activate so that MeshCentral will reject users that are using passwords that are well known, or fairly common. Database record encryption. This, instead of encrypting the entire database, and regardless of what database you use, whether it's NEDB, the built-in one, or you use the MongoDB, MySQL, or MariaDB, you can have MeshCentral encrypt some of the more sensitive parts of any record. And so you you enable that feature, and then that part of the record will be encrypted. Let's see. HTTP content security, we put the right headers on HTTP. FIDO2, this is an extra support for two-factor authentication for FIDO keys. And so I have right here in my hand a USB token. I highly recommend, if you use MeshCentral quite a bit, to get one of these. There's multiple varieties of them. They're about $20 on eBay or stuff like that. And you plug them in and they serve as a quick two-factor authentication for your login. Highly recommended. And of course, MeshCentral fully supports it. IP address token binding. Whenever MeshCentral issues a token of, or like an encrypted cookie to a remote user, the encrypted cookie will include the IP address that this cookie came from. And so if the cookie is stolen and used from another address, it won't work anymore. Now, this is an optional thing, but it's on by default. Reverse proxy support. Now, this is nice in general, but it is also relevant for security, because if your reverse proxy has additional security policies, additional security measures, or it has the TLS certificate for your server, then MeshCentral doesn't have to do that, and MeshCentral doesn't have to know about your server's TLS certificate or something, things like that. So it's an extra layer of protection if you place a reverse proxy, especially with strong security policies in front of MeshCentral. The other one is HashiCorp Vault support. This we haven't used very much, but basically the idea is that you can set up put the config.json file of MeshCentral inside a vault, and then it's retrieved when needed. So that's an extra place where you keep all the secrets of MeshCentral. You keep it in a safe place there. And then the last one in this document is strong password hashing. So when a user enters a password to create an account, the password is hashed using 12,000 rounds of SHA-384, and there's a strong salt, which is like a random number that is used for all those rounds of hashing. So the resulting hash, even if somebody steals your database, it's going to be some work to brute force all those passwords. And so, again, extra level of security. So these are just some of the security features of MeshCentral. Obviously, if you find anything, the idea is that the community will constantly investigate the code base, make sure it's strong. And so if you have any concerns, please contact me. Go to the GitHub page and send me an email address. Also, on the contact page the website, there is my PGP key. So if there's something sensitive, you can use the PGP key, encrypt something, and then only I will be able to decrypt it. So that's it for security with MeshCentral. I hope this has been an instructive video. Thank you very much, and have a nice day.